Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve problem 2.52 of the textbook First Course in Probability. So the problem says the following. You assume that you have a closet with exactly 10 pairs of shoes and you take exactly 8 shoes, not 8 pairs, but 8 shoes. And the goal is to find little a, the probability that we have no complete pair, and little b, the probability of having exactly one complete pair. So let me draw a picture of that first. So you have basically 10 pairs of shoes. So that means 20 shoes. So 20 pairs of shoes. Okay, you are going to take from that 8 shoes at random, and the goal is to find the probability of 0 pair and the probability of exactly 1 pair. So it turns out that this problem is in fact similar to poker, except that instead of playing with cards, you play with shoes, more or less. That's kind of the idea, but it's really the same thing. Instead of having 13 denominations, you are going to have 10 denominations, okay? And instead of having four suits, you are going to have only 2 suits corresponding to the left foot and the right foot, okay? But you just slightly change the numbers, but it's exactly the same as poker. And so what we need to compute is very similar to poker probabilities. But again, using a deck of 20 cards divided into 10 denominations times 2 suits. So now that we have this in mind, if you saw my previous video about poker probabilities, then you will see kind of the idea. So first question, we want to look at the probability of 0 pair, probability of no complete pair. Okay, so here in how many ways we can choose 8 shoes so that they are not from the same pair, so kind of not from the same denomination. Well, step one, to make sure that you indeed take your 8 shoes from 8 from 8 different pairs, you are going to choose 8 different pairs. Okay, so that's going to be, to begin with, a 10 choose 8. That's the number of ways you can choose 8 pairs, not taking the pairs, but choosing 8 pairs in your mind from which you are going to take your 8 shoes eventually. So you start with a 10 choose 8. And then once you have 8 pairs in your mind and you still need to take one shoe from each pair, you have obviously 2 possibilities for each pair, right or left. I'm going to write this as a 2 choose 1. But you still need to choose one shoe from each of the 8 pairs. And so you need to look at this raised at the power 8. Okay? So that gives you your total number of possible choices of 8 shoes from this set of 20 shoes in such a way that no 2 of them are from the same pair. Now, to get your probability, you need to divide by the total number of outcomes. In this case, because you have 10 pairs, that's 20 shoes, you choose 8 of them. So that's a 20 choose 8. That's the size of the sample space. So 20 choose 8, the size of the sample space. And so that's going to give you this number, the probability that you have 0 pair, 0 complete pair. If you use a calculator to compute that number, you will find that the probability of no complete pair is about equal to 0.09145. Okay, now, next question, B. We need to compute the probability of exactly one pair. Okay. Then, in this case, a little bit in the spirit of, again, poker probabilities, the first step is to say, well, let's choose one of the 10 pairs from which we are going to take our 2 shoes. So the number of possibilities here is 10, choose one. Okay, you have 10 possibilities for the pair. Then you want to take both shoes from this pair. So that's a 2 choose 2, that's equal to 1. I'm still going to write it so that you see the pattern and the reasoning. Then at this stage, you have exactly 2 shoes. You still need to choose to take 6 more, okay? 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. You need 6 more shoes to take. And you want to make sure that they are not from the same pair. You already chose one pair to have your complete pair. And so you still need to choose 6 of the 9 remaining pairs. Okay? So that gives you a 9, choose 6. Okay? So that's number of ways you can choose 6 of the remaining pairs. And you are going to take your six remaining shoes from those 6 pairs. Exactly like before, you have 2 possibilities for each pair because you have, you know, 2 shoes, right or left. So you have a 2 choose 1 like here, but now rest at the power 6. Okay? And as before, you need to divide that by 20 choose 8, the size of the sample space, to get your probability. Now again, if you use a calculator to compute that number, you would find that the probability of having exactly one complete pair is about equal to 0.4268.